Hello and welcome kids, once again to your science classes of grade 5th. In this part of the video, we are going to discuss the book exercises, given book exercises of our second chapter, that is food and health. But before that, I would like you to have a quick recap of the important subtopics or whatever we have discussed and studied in this chapter. So the very first thing was about food, that food is very important for our health and well-being. It gives energy to do work, keeps us fit and active, protect us from diseases. We get food from both plants and animals. So this much you all know now about food, that why the food is important. Yes, because by eating food only we get energy to do different kinds of work. It keeps us fit and healthy, active. The protective food, it protects us from diseases. And yes, we get food from both plants and animals. Okay. Now the next important subtopic was about components of food. Food contains certain substances called nutrients. And the name of those five nutrients were carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals, including water and roughage. Then there was about balanced diet. So these are the before discussing balanced diet, because balanced diet is only comprised of these nutrients in a healthy and balanced and adequate amount. So these are the nutrients which build up our food items, which are present in different food items. Okay, carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals, water and roughage. So these name, this spelling should be learned to you. What is a balanced diet? Balanced diet is a diet that contains all the nutrients in proper amounts required for the healthy functioning of our body. Yes, we should not only take a diet, we should take a balanced diet. As you can see, it is very much becoming apparent from this picture that yes, this picture consists of a balanced diet. As you can see over here, components of a balanced diet. What are the all components which consist a balanced diet? We should not take only our diet or meal. It should be balanced also. Balanced means it should contain protective food portion also. It should contain carbohydrate nutrients also. It should contain proteins food section also, and little bit of fats also. Good quality of fat, but in limited amount. Okay, so that diet is known as a balanced diet, because if we will consume balanced diet, then only it will help us in the proper and healthy functioning of our body. Okay, so all these were components of food, and all the functions, you know that carbohydrates gives us energy, and all the cereals, corn, potato, bread, sugar, they are the sources of carbohydrates, fats. Excessive intake of fatty foods can cause obesity. Thus also you know that we should not take fat in excessive amount. We should take it in control amount, and it gives more energy than carbohydrates. Examples are milk, ghee, butter. Proteins help in building our body muscles and tissues, and it also helps in repairing the worn out or damaged cells and tissues of our body. Milk, paneer, pulses, beans, eggs. Vitamins and minerals help in the normal functioning of our body and help in protecting our body against diseases. Fruits, vegetables, milk are some sources of vitamins and minerals. And especially you should take vitamin C, as it helps to keep the gums and teeth healthy. And calcium makes our bones and teeth strong. Then besides nutrients, our body also needs water and roughage. Roughage is the undigested part of the plant food, or we can also call it plant fiber, which are present in all the raw fruits and vegetables like carrots, radish, beetroot, cucumber, etc. And it helps in getting rid of waste from our body, or in other way we can say it helps in the proper digestion of the food. It assists digesting the food. Okay. Then we have discussed some healthy habits. Like we should take balanced diet, we should do proper exercise, we should take proper amount of rest, and we should maintain correct posture while sitting or standing, as it is depicted from these pictures also. Okay, so these were some healthy habits. Then coming to the first book exercise. So let's solve the first book exercise. Here it is given, write T for true and F for false statements. So you have to judge whether the given statement is true and or whether the given statement is false. So let's see the first statement. Carbohydrates and fats give energy to our body. Yes, true. Both the nutrients are called energy giving nutrients. So it is a true statement. Then second, calcium makes our bones and teeth weak. No. Right now we have studied that calcium makes our bones and teeth strong. It provides strength to our bones and teeth. Okay, so it is a false statement. Calcium makes our bones and teeth strong, not weak. So it is a false statement. Next, roughage is the undigested part of the animal food. No, it is a wrong word. Roughage is the undigested part of the plant food, okay, not the animal food. So it is again a false statement. Fourth, eggs and meat are sources of proteins. Yes, in the examples of sources of proteins, we have seen that eggs and meats, they are sources of protein. As you can see over here, this is egg and this is meat. Okay, so eggs and meat are sources of proteins. So it is a true statement. Our body does not need water and roughage. No, it is a false statement. Our body needs proper amount of roughage for the proper digestion of food and to get rid of waste from our body and water also. Okay, then we have studied about the topic diseases. It is an abnormal condition in which our body does not function properly. It can occur due to lack of any nutrient, that is called deficiency disease in our diet, and may occur also due to germs. So disease is such a condition in which we feel low, we are not healthy, we feel weak, tired, and some or the other body functions in our body, inside our body, it is not working properly. There is some ailment in our body. And these diseases, they can occur due to the deficiency, due to the lack of any nutrient in our diet. And those are known as deficiency disease, although they can also come in the category of non-communicable diseases. And some diseases, they are caused due to germs and they are known as communicable diseases. Okay, that's what it is written over here. Diseases could be categorized in two parts, communicable, non-communicable. In the communicable part, you can see that the diseases that can spread from one person to another through germs like malaria, conjunctivitis, typhoid, and non-communicable that do not pass from one person to another, and they can cause due to deficiency of any particular nutrient, vitamins, or minerals in the body. Example, scurvy and rickets. And the same thing I have shown over here in this picture also. This diagram depicts the disease, deficiency disease, scurvy. This is of rickets. This is of goiter. It happens due to the deficiency of mineral iodine, and there is swelling in a gland which is present in the neck region. Rickets is caused due to the deficiency of vitamin D, and the legs become bow-shaped, and they are very weak. And the scurvy, it is caused due to the deficiency of vitamin C. It is caused due to the deficiency of vitamin C. There is swelling and bleeding of gums and teeth. So, with this topic, this table is very important that I have told you. And I have uploaded the PDF of this lesson also on the Snapbook. So, please go through the lesson. Okay, do reading of the lesson and try to draw these tables. Okay, this table in your notebook. And I have told you that you have to do your science work of grade fifth in your grade fourth science notebook, that is previous year science notebook. Must be blank pages, must be there, so you can use that only. In one of the page, you just write session 2020-21, class 5th, science work. And from the next page, you can start doing your science work. Remember, the work should be neat and clean. It should be topic-wise. The name of the topic must be written before you start any kind of work. Okay? It should be maintained properly, sequentially, and the question should also be written. Then only you will write down the answers. Okay? Okay. So these are some of the deficiency diseases shown in the chart. First is night blindness. It is caused due to deficiency of vitamin A. Person is not able to see in dim light. Dim means very low light, poor quality of light. It can be cured by consuming green leafy vegetables, carrot, papaya, mango, milk and egg yolk. Then the next disease is beriberi. It is caused by the deficiency of vitamin B1. Person has weak muscles, nerves and get cramps. Cramps means he get muscular pain, like sometimes you are having a stomach ache, that kind of thing. It can be cured by eating unpolished rice, means brown rice, cereals, milk, peas and meat. Scurvy, it is caused by the deficiency of vitamin C. Symptoms are bleeding of gums and swelling of joints. Can be cured by consuming apple, orange, lemon, tomato and amla, all the citrus fruits. They contain rich source of vitamin C. They are rich source of vitamin C. Then rickets, it is caused due to deficiency of vitamin D. We have already seen it. Soft bones and bow legs are the symptoms. Milk and fish, sunlight also helps our body to make vitamin D, natural sunlight. Then goiter, this was the goiter. It is caused due to the deficiency of iodine. There is swelling of a gland in neck region. It can be cured by consuming iodized salt and seafoods. Then there was anemia. It is caused due to the deficiency of iron. Person gets tired easily and looks pale. Spinach, brinjal, jaggery, apple, guava and meat should be consumed to cure it. Then we have seen the communicable disease, the four types of germs or microbes or microorganisms which are responsible for the causing of this communicable disease. This was bacteria, virus, protozoa, fungi. These were the name of the disease. Bacteria cause plague, tuberculosis, typhoid, pneumonia and cholera. Viruses cause common cold, polio, measles, chickenpox, flu and AIDS. Protozoa cause malaria, kalazar and amoebic dysentery. Fungi causes infections of skin and athlete's foot. Then there were some of the name of the communicable disease, their symptoms and what preventive measures we can adopt to stop them. Okay, so this table also, it is very important, and in my previous videos also related to this chapter, I have told you to draw this table. Okay. Now then we have studied about the topic, how these communicable diseases spread. They can spread through air, through direct contact, through infected food and water, and through insects. These were the four carriers, four means by which these communicable diseases could spread. And one by one we have discussed is also that if a sick person coughs, sneezes or spits, then germs are released into the air, and when a healthy person breathes that air, he or she may also get sick because germs take entry inside his or her body that were present in that air where that sick person has sneezed or coughed without covering his mouth or nose. So you should always remember that you should cover your mouth and nose properly with a handkerchief while sneezing, coughing or discharging any kind of liquid waste from your body, especially through mouth and nose. Okay, while spitting, no one can put a handkerchief on his or her mouth, but he should be very much careful that we should not spit here and there. We should properly spit in the wash basins and in a drain or something like that. Then there was through direct contact. When a healthy person comes in contact with a sick person or his handkerchief, or I have told you with his personal belongings like towel, clothes, then the chances are that he or she can get infected by germs. Example of the disease were like measles, chickenpox, ringworm. Through infected food and water, if the food and water they are not covered up properly, they are not kept and maintained properly, handled properly, then flies and cockroaches, they can also contaminate our food with germs. Diseases like cholera, typhoid, jaundice, and polio, they spread through infected food and water. And in case of insect category, we have seen diseases like malaria, dengue, plague, and chikungunya, they spread through blood-sucking insects like mosquitoes, bugs, and flies. Malaria is caused by a protozoan that is carried by the female Anopheles mosquito. This is female Anopheles mosquito. It carries the protozoan inside her body that can cause malaria. Okay? And dengue is spread by the bite of Aedes mosquito. Plague is spread by the bite of fleas carried by rats. Now there is again one book exercise which I have told you to do by yourself, that write down one example of the disease caused by the following germs. You have to write down one example of the disease. You have to write down at least two examples, not one. Two examples of the disease caused by the following germs. So bacteria causes what? One example I am writing, one you will write by yourself. Typhoid we have seen. Virus, it causes flu. And protozoa, it causes malaria. One more disease you are going to write by yourself, okay? Then we have studied how we can prevent the spread of communicable disease. Yes, by following proper neatness, cleanliness, hygiene in and around ourselves, we can prevent the spread of all these communicable diseases to some extent. Like we should wash our hands before and after eating food and after going to the toilet with soap and water. We should not allow water to stand in ditches, in any kind of containers, vessels, coolers, pots in and around our house, because stagnant water only allows the breeding of mosquitoes, and these mosquitoes could be the carrier of dangerous germs like dengue, chikungunya, etc. Then use mosquito net or mosquito repellent at night. Wash fruits and vegetables well before cooking or eating them. Yes. Fruits and vegetables also need to be washed properly before consuming. Food must be kept covered to prevent flies sitting on it. We have to protect our food also. We have to keep them covered so that the flies, cockroaches could not come in contact with that. Do not allow heaps of garbage to collect near your home. Dustbins should be kept covered. We should use covered bins in our home. And you should drink clean water. And it can be made clean and germ-free by boiling, then filtering and chlorinating. Then there was a topic of vaccination. It is another way of preventing communicable diseases. Vaccines are available to prevent diseases like polio, cholera, diphtheria, tetanus, and hepatitis. Vaccination helps our body to acquire, to adopt, to develop immunity against certain diseases. And about vaccination, we have seen that what is a vaccine? It contains a microorganisms in a weakened or killed state from the organisms itself. And vaccination is the administration of this vaccine to help the immune system develop protection from a disease. So this I have already explained to you. And then there were the keywords. This let's memorize section this time. It is only the keywords or definition section of the chapter, which is given at the last of the chapter. So you have to write these keywords also, okay, in the notebook. Deficiency diseases that occur due to lack of, due to the shortage of certain vitamins and minerals in our diet are called deficiency diseases. Communicable diseases that can spread from one person to another are called communicable diseases. And over here it was about balanced diet diseases and non-communicable diseases. Now let's move on to the next book exercise. It is tick the correct answer. As you know, one statement will be given and four options will be given. Out of those four options, the one very appropriate, very correct option you have to tick mark. So, what is the first statement? Which of the following gives more energy than carbohydrates? You have to find out that nutrient which gives more energy than carbohydrates. So, we know fats is one such nutrient which gives more energy than कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स. सो इट इज रिटन ओवर हियर प्रोटीन्स फैट्स वाइटमिन्स एंड मिनरल्स. सो फैट्स विल कम ओवर हियर. ओके फैट्स विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. नेक्स्ट विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज अ डेफिशिएंसी डिजीज. नाउ अनेमिया मलेरिया टाइफॉइड कॉलेरा. नाउ यू नो दिस मलेरिया टाइफॉइड एंड कॉलेरा दे आर ऑल कम्युनिकेबल डिजीज. दे कैन स्प्रेड फ्रॉम एन इन्फेक्टेड पर्सन टू अ हेल्दी पर्सन. बट दिस अनेमिया इट इज़ अ डेफिशियंसी डिजीज. इट अकर्स ड्यू टू द डेफिशियंसी ऑफ आयरन इन द बॉडी. सो दिस इज अ डेफिशियंसी डिजीज. दिस विल बी द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. थर्ड विच डिजीज इज कॉज्ड बाई द डेफिशियंसी ऑफ वाइटामिन डी. स्कर्वी रिकेट्स मिजल्स एंड बेरी बेरी. सो इट इज रिकेट्स. रिकेट्स इज कॉज्ड बाई द डेफिशियंसी ऑफ वाइटामिन डी. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट अ कम्युनिकेबल डिजीज. नाउ यू हैव टू अगेन फाइंड विच इज नॉट अ कम्युनिकेबल डिजीज. देन मिजल्स कॉलेरा मलेरिया गॉइटर. सो गॉइटर बिकॉज इट इज अ डेफिशियंसी डिजीज. इट अकर्स ड्यू टू द डेफिशियंसी ऑफ आयोडीन इन द डाइट. स्कर्वी इट इज कॉज्ड बाई द डेफिशियंसी ऑफ विच वाइटमिन. वाइटमिन ए वाइटमिन बी वाइटमिन सी वाइटमिन डी. सो इट इज कॉज्ड बाई द डेफिशियंसी ऑफ वाइटमिन सी. द डेफिशियंसी ऑफ वाइटमिन ए कॉजेज नाइट ब्लाइंडनेस. डेफिशियंसी ऑफ वाइटमिन बी कॉजेज बेरी बेरी. डेफिशियंसी ऑफ वाइटमिन डी कॉजेज रिकेट्स. बट द डेफिशियंसी ऑफ वाइटमिन सी कॉजेज द डिजीज कॉल्ड स्कर्वी इन विच देर इज स्वेलिंग ऑफ गम्स और ब्लीडिंग ऑफ गम्स एंड द टीथ बिकम्स वीक. Moving on to the next book exercise, that is fill in the blanks with the correct words. Some blank statement must be given and options should be given. Options are given. Out of those options, you have to choose the correct option for each of the blank. Okay. So first one, sugar and bread, they are sources of dash. Out of this, what will be the correct? Yes, carbohydrates. Sugar and bread, they are sources of carbohydrates. So carbohydrates will come over in this blank. Second, dash help in repairing the damaged cells of our body. Which nutrient help in the damaged cells repairing? Yes, proteins. Proteins help in building our muscles, cells and tissues in the growth and development of the body, and it also helps in repairing. If there is some cut, some injury in our muscles, cells or tissues, then protein is the nutrient which helps to heal it, to cure it. Okay. Third, dash makes our bones and teeth strong. Yes, calcium. Calcium is the mineral which makes our bones and teeth strong, and milk is a very rich source of it. Fourth, proper rest and dash relax our muscles. So obviously sleep, if we will take proper rest and sleep for at least 6 to 7 hours, we should take a sound sleep, and we should also give proper rest so that our body, our muscles, it could also relax. Okay. Fifth, goiter is caused due to the deficiency of, yes, only one is left, iodine. So it is goiter is caused due to the deficiency of iodine. Now name the following. This section of the question you will do by yourself. I am just explaining it. The diseases caused by the deficiency of vitamin B1. One of the diseases you have to write over here, which is caused, which occurs due to the deficiency of vitamin B1. That means that is a deficiency disease. That you have to write. If you will follow the video, you could be able to do this section of the question. Second, it improves our blood circulation and tones up our muscles. What we will do in the sub part that was called healthy habits, some of the healthy habits, some of the things which we have discussed, that helps and improves, that makes good our blood circulation and also tones up our muscles. So what is that body activity which we will do, which will result in improving our blood circulation and toning up our muscles? That you have to write over here. Okay. Third, the undigested part of plant food. You have to mention one undigested part of the plant food. What it is called. Okay. That we have studied in the nutrient that was called water and roughage. So that you have to write over here. Two diseases caused by bacteria. You have to write the name of any two diseases which is caused by the bacteria. Bacterial diseases. Any two diseases you will write. Make sure spelling should be correct. Okay. The insect which spreads malaria. Now you have to write over here the name of that insect which is the carrier of malaria. Actually the malaria is caused by the microorganism that is called protozoa. मलेरिया इज अ प्रोटोजोअन टाइप ऑफ डिजीज, बट विच इज द करियर ऑर्गेनिज्म, विच इज दैट करियर इंसेक्ट विच स्प्रेड्स दिस मलेरिया, दैट करियर इंसेक्ट नेम यू हैव टू राइट ओवर हियर. ओके, सो दिस वॉज ऑल फॉर दिस पोर्शन ऑफ द वीडियो. आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड. इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस दिस क्वेश्चन आंसर्स. ओके, सो टिल देन बाय, टेक केयर एंड थैंक यू फॉर द क्लास.